welcome back from that short commercial break, and we're still talking to the goddess, the queen herself. Yes, she's the goddess of embroidery, of beadwork, and she's here to take Uganda by storm. Ladies and gentlemen, SKP by Sheebah Kasami Pemba. Welcome back from that short commercial break. My name is Jerm, and you're still watching the Abba and Fashionista. Let's dissect Sheebah and get to know more about her. Ladies and gentlemen, follow me in as I take you through the empire of SKP by Sheebah Kasami Pemba. What a lovely surprise. And I see the diva herself, Irene. Hi, Irene.
Hi, how are you?
Very well, thank you. I'm starstruck right now. And that kaftan looks amazing on you. So, Sheebah, what inspired this?
Well, this is for a gospel song that she's working on, and we're trying to look for a more flowy dress with a bit of more beadwork. So we're still in the making of the outfits. We've not yet finished the beadwork, as you see. So we need to first see what she's looking for. She needs to look like an angel, because her song is a gospel song for this specific outfit.
So Irene, just one more question for you. Why Sheebah and not any other designer? Why SKP by Sheebah?
Because she's the best and she is my friend, so I want to support her. Not only because she's my friend, but I think she's very good at it. Look at the material. Look at the fabric. Look at the stones. All handmade. You see?
This is my favorite prayer. The Lord is my shepherd. Psalms 23. That's my favorite verse. It says, look at the nations and watch, and you'll be utterly amazed, for I'm going to do something in your days that the world, that would not, you would not believe even if you were told. In other words, God will do a miracle in your life that even if you told people, they'll never believe you. So that's my favorite verse.
Amen.
My animal is the leopard. Many people say I have the same character as the leopard. Do you know the character of the leopard?
Tell me.
The character of the leopard is very protective of its own. And once it attacks, it doesn't miss, and it doesn't fight every fight. You must learn to choose your battles.
I love that. So tell me, where do you draw the inspiration for all this art, for the interior designing? Because I see you select your pieces very, very well. What do you consider when you're selecting your art pieces?
I consider the piece that catches my eye and the one that I think will tell a story. Mm-hmm. Those are birds flying into the forest, mm-hmm. if you can see what I was trying to say. And some, those ones are going to the sea, and that's a goose.
And you are one designer that I've seen that, you know, marries both fashion designing and then interior designing. How are your charges like in case someone wanted to hire you to do interior designing for them?
To be honest, interior design is a passion. I don't even know how to charge it. So I try, I try not to do interior for unless you're my friend, because I'll end up giving you the charges of the actual fabric or the furniture, and I'll not know how to charge because it's not my strong point.
Fantastic. So what are the major factors that any person out there that is watching you that would love to venture into fashion design and then interior design to, you know, marry both?
Design, when you want to do an accentuating wall, always make sure that it's on the area of the shadow. Did you know that? Like,
why?
If you put the dark wall on the light, where the light hits, it doesn't bounce, so it creates a shadow in the house. If you put it on the shadow, it creates character. You see that that is in the shadow, and then it creates character.
And then how do you come about with the lighting and then all that? How do you select your lighting bit?
I don't know, because I used to be an art student, and I did so well in art in school. So probably that's where I got the talent, because between light and shadow, I studied it in school.
Fantastic. So I know all the urban fashionistas have been dying for this. How does it feel like to be married to a mogul, someone that has made it as, I'm not going to call him a socialite, but an investor, a business mogul, Jack Pemba?
Oh, Jack Pemba is an amazing person. I feel so great to be married to him. I'm spoiled, rotten, I'm pampered. He loves people, he loves giving. He's a big giver, he gives to charities, to sports, he works hard. Actually, what people don't know is that he's such a hard worker, very hard worker. He's a good parent, he's a very good father, he's very entrepreneuring, he's very driven. What you see out there in the club is only on his playtime, which is not every day. Yeah, so he's an amazing person, and I'm very lucky to have him.
And then I know the urban fashionistas are dying for this. It's the final one. With all the drama that is going on right now on social media about everything, how are you handling this? How true is this?
First and foremost, it's not true. Absolutely not true. Absolutely not true. That's not him in that video. And another thing is that I wouldn't blame the girl. Who wouldn't want to be attached to fame?
I know.
Like, seriously, we're good on her if that's how she makes it in life. But no, but jokes aside, I think God bless her, because I think she's disturbed for her to do that. But he's a very God-fearing man who'd never do that. He's a very hard-working entrepreneur who gives a lot to society, who's very cautious about his image. So hopefully the young generation of the girl does not learn from her to do what she has done, and learn to work harder and bring out the dignity in a woman and self-respect for oneself. Because I saw on the internet she was bragging. She was excited.
I know so many urban fashionistas are waiting to see what Joram has for you under the style tips. Keep it locked. Let's speak fashion. Ladies and gentlemen, the urban fashionista style tips. Tip number one. Go shopping solo. Trust your gut, because sometimes friends give you the worst advice. Yes, they do. If you don't think your friends have the exact same style as you do, don't shop with them. Style tip number two. Before buying a statement piece, ask yourself one question. Does this accentuate the best version of who I am as a man or a woman? It is a brilliant trick for making sure that your purchase is something you'll actually wear. If you feel like yourself in a piece of clothing, you are more likely to gravitate towards it when it's hanging on your closet. Style tip number three. Opt for a trend that will stick around for a while. Yes, trends do come and go, but always get looks that are timeless and have more season longevity. Style tip number four. Consider even the most minute details. Adding the most delicate details to anything that you wear will make you pop. Style tip number five. Flaunt it because you got it. Believe in your body type and dressing for your body type, as well as opposed to hiding it. Style tip number six. Ease into a more colorful wardrobe. Some colors are absolutely timeless. Take an example of red, which is absolutely so timeless. It is bright and bold and goes with everything. It is such a strong and empowering color. So yes, the urban fashionistas, ease into more colorful wardrobe. Style tip number seven. Push yourself with something new. If you always wear jeans the whole time, try swapping them for a dress once a week. If you're a fan of flats, slip into a pair of heels every Friday night. Getting out of your comfort zone is a good way to challenge yourself in the self-confidence department. Style tip number eight. Yes, you should buy something impractical. Allow yourself to spend on something special. Everyone loves to dress up, even if it's just at home. Go the whole way out if need be sometimes. You only live once. Don't take yourself so seriously. Style tip number nine. Use Pinterest and Instagram for everyday inspiration. I practically do this the whole time on a daily basis, so I believe it could work magic for you, the urban fashionistas. You check the app first thing after your alarm goes off in the morning, so why not let it influence your outfit for the day? And lastly, style tip number 10. Don't forget to build a solid foundation for basics. Always ensure that the wardrobe has the basics that you can always build on, like white tees, vintage denim, a succulent shirting, perfect tailoring, a pointed pump for the ladies, simple chinos and moccasins for the guys. Simply adding little pieces to the basics pulls off an incredible look at any time. The urban fashionistas hope you've enjoyed the style tips. Keep it locked on the app and Fashionista.